Greetings. Welcome from Uttar Pradesh Ashwini Open University. Friends, today we are going to take an important topic of MCOM 107. Block 1, Unit 2, Correlation. As you all know, in business statistics, correlation is one of the important and vital statistical tools which is being highly used in any of the business decisions, in research, in all the activity of business, management, and commerce. As you all know, that correlation is a statistical tool in which we use to relate between the two series or more than two series. This is a statistical tool which is applicable for both quantitative terms and qualitative terms. It is one of the important statistical tool, as all those who have a little and primary knowledge of statistics can apply this tool, as well as all the learners who have got a good command over mathematics can also apply these tools. There are various methods by which we can calculate the correlation. Now let's see that what is correlation. Correlation is a statistical technique to ascertain the association of relationship between two or more variables. Correlation analysis is a statistical technique to study the degree and direction of relationship between two or more variables. Here we used to see that both the degree, the relationship between the two degrees is being ascertained by this statistical tool, as well as the direction. Direction means that whether the two series is positively correlated or negatively correlated, whether this has got a positive impact. Now for an example, we will take an example here that whenever we used to see the flow of money in the market and the price of the product, the more the flow of market in the product, the more the price will be. The more the money flow in the market, the more will be the price of the product. Whenever the flow of money is less, the cost of the product is less. In another example, we will see that if we used to have a rainfall and the production of the crops, more the rainfall, more will be the production of the crops. Less the rainfall, there is a directly impact on the production of the crop. Same way, if you take an example, that for example, we all used to apply oil, hair oil. So application of hair oil and the growth of the hairs. If you take a new hair oil and you apply it, and it suits on your body, automatically there is a growth in your hairs. Means the application of the hair oil and the growth of the hairs means it is being positively correlated. Why we use correlation? We use correlation for different decision makings. Whenever we have to compare between the two values, between the two companies, between anything, we have to relate that whether it has a positive impact on the other or not, we used to apply the correlation. Whenever we have to see the impact of one series on the another series, we used to apply the correlation. Whenever we have to see that the impact of a certain thing on a certain product is positive or negative, we have to apply correlation. So correlation used to be highly used in the business and commerce field. Types of correlation. We have got mainly three types of correlation. The first is positive and negative correlation. So here one thing we have to know, that the value of correlation should always be from minus 1 to plus 1. The value of correlation should always be from minus 1 to plus 1. Whenever we say that the value of the correlation is in plus, is in positive direction from 0 to 1. We say that it is positive correlated. And same way, when the value decreases from 0 to minus 1, we say it is a negative correlation. So, same way, simple correlation, partial correlation, and multiple correlation. Simple correlation, when we correlate the two values, we say that is a simple correlation. Partial correlation means the impact of one series on the other series is partially affected. It is a partial correlation. And multiple correlation means we are relating the two series, X series and Y series, but there is an impact of Z series also over there. Then we used to say it's a multiple correlation. The third one is the linear and non-linear correlation. Whenever the value of correlation lies extremely with the value of the other series, that is X series lies with the Y series, we say it is a linear correlation. While when the two series are not in the same line, we say it is a non-linear or curvilinear correlation. Now, methods of measurement of correlation. There are different methods given by the different statisticians to calculate the correlation. Some of the methods are very simple, where everyone can solve the problem, while some of the methods need expertise and mathematical knowledge to solve the correlation. Now you see, there are three ways by which we can calculate the correlation. The first one is the scatter diagram. In a scatter diagram method, what we used to do is this, that we take, in a scatter diagram, we take a table or a graph and we check there are different points of X series and Y series, and we correlate anything like this, and we say that the X series is directly or positively correlated with the Y series. Now for graphic method, we used to take the help of graphs. We used to take the help of graph to take out the correlation between the same two series. Same way, in the scatter diagram, we have scattered the diagram and we have taken the best values by which a line used to go. In the graphic method, we used to take a graph, we put the value over here, and again we make a line and we see that the both X and Y series are positively correlated or negatively correlated. The third method, which is also known as the mathematical methods, is highly used in taking any of the decisions or research and development in the field of business, management, and commerce. Here, three most popular methods are being used to calculate the correlation. The first one is Carl Pearson method. It is being given by the Carl Pearson. This is highly used method to calculate the correlation. The formula for calculating the Carl Pearson correlation is, this is the coefficient of correlation, summation x y upon n standard deviation of 1 and standard deviation of 2. This is the formula to calculate the Carl Pearson correlation method. Here, summation x y stands for the summating value, the sum of x series and the y series. We take the x series, we take y series, and we multiply both series, and we sum up that value. It is the summation x y. While n is the number of terms each series possess. For example, if we are taking the heights of 10 jawans, so we are going to write 10 over here. The weight of 10 jawans, we used to write 10 over here. N is the number of values which is being there in X series or Y series. While standard deviation of 1 and standard deviation of 2 is the respective standard deviation of X series and Y series. Now, the second method is concurrent deviation method. This method is highly used in the field of arts and commerce where we don't have got the exact value, where we used to deal with the qualitative data. Qualitative data means any data which is being ranked, any data which is being given in more or less form. The formula for calculating the concurrent deviation is plus minus under root plus minus 2c minus n upon n. Here you see there is a term known as c. C stands for the positive and the negative signs of the series. Here what we used to do is we have got X series and we have got Y series. And we used to see that the preceding number or the preceding value which is being preceded by the first term is more or less. When the value is more, we used to write the plus sign. If the value is less, we write the minus sign. For example, you have got 5, 8, 10, 7, 4. So this is X series. So here there is no preceding term, first term. So we leave a gap over here. 5, 8, 8 is more than 5. We write plus over here. 10, 10 is more than 8. We write plus over here. 7, 7 is less than 10. We write minus over here. 4, 4 is less than 7. We write minus. So C, C over here is the positive sign, plus sign. For this 5 terms, we used to write that C is equal to 2. Same way, we calculate the value of Y series also. And after calculating both, we have got a term X series, Y series, plus plus, minus minus, plus minus, and minus plus. So these are the four conditions which prevails. Plus plus, same sign is positive. Minus minus, same sign is positive. Plus minus, opposite sign is negative. Minus plus is negative. Sometimes what happened, the value is same. For example, 4, and after 4, another value 4 is being given over here. So what you are going to do? You are going to put a sign of equal to over here. So another term comes over here, equal to plus is equal to minus, minus equal to is equal to minus, equal to is equal to plus. So these conditions prevail over here. So you've seen the formula, plus minus under root plus minus 2c minus n upon n. One thing more is taken care over here is this, that for n, if you see n over here, I have told you that number of terms in a series, if we are going to take the data of 10 learners, 10 students, so for Carl Pearson, we are going to write 10 over here. But for concurrent deviation method, we are not going to write 10 over here. We are going to write 9 over here because the first one, the first series hasn't have got a pair of it. You see over here, the first series, we don't know that before this is a positive sign or a negative sign. So we left a blank over here. So this term is not considered over here. So we are going to write 9 over here. Now, there is another method known as rank correlation, commonly known as Spearman-Rank correlation. This is the statistical tool which is being used for all the qualitative data. Qualitative data means all the data which is being taken in terms of rank. For example, fragrance. If you go and ask the respondent that which type of fragrance you like, you ask the quality of the food, they ranked it. This is better than this, this is better than that. So here ranking comes. When we used to take the data of the two series X and Y and rank them according to their ascending order or descending order, we used to say that we are going to apply the Spearman rank correlation. The formula for calculating Spearman rank correlation is, write R over here, is 1 minus summation D square upon N square minus 1. So this is the formula of calculating the Spearman rank correlation, where N is a constant, we have to take the value, while D square is the difference between the rank X and rank Y. We have got two values, we used to take out the difference of it and we squared the value. We are going and sum of that value we are going to get over here, summation D square. Now here N square minus 1 is the number of terms in X series and the number of terms in Y series which we are calculating. Same way as we have taken in Carl Pearson, if we are going to take the data of 10 learners, we are going to write 10 over here. Same way, if we are going to take the data of 10 learners, we are going to write 10 over here. So these three methods are highly applicable to calculate the correlation. So for all the learners, for all the students who know, who are from mathematical backgrounds, used to go with this Carl Pearson method, because in this method you must know how to calculate the standard deviation, you must know how to take the mean value, and after calculating the mean value and the standard deviation, you can solve the question. In concurrent cooperative division, it is a simple method, anyone can use, because everyone knows that the other value, the preceding value, is more or less. You must have a primary knowledge of this. Same sign is equal to positive, opposite sign is equal to negative, and according to that, you get the value of C. C is the total number of positive sign in the series, and you calculate this. When the data is in a qualitative form, we used to apply the rank correlation. In rank correlation, we used to take the rank, we take out the difference of that rank, we used to square up that value, sum of that value, and we get the value of summation D square, and according to the value of N, we calculate. Now these are the three methods. I hope you will get it. These are the two, scatter diagram and graphic diagram, which is simple, anyone can solve. The three methods for mathematical background is Carl Pearson, concurrent deviation, and rank correlation. The formulas are here. I hope you have understand. Let's take an example to understand in a better way. Given below are the ages of husband X and wife Y at the time of marriage. Find the correlation between them. Here, two series has been given. X series and Y series is being given, and here the average ages of the husband X is husband, this is husband, and this is wife. So 25, 22, 28, 26, 35, 20, 22, 40, 20, 48, 19, 25, these are the ages of husband. Means an individual, when he got married, the age of that person is this. Same way, the ages of wife, means when the girl used to get married, the average age is this. So now we have to correlate that whether these two data are positively correlated or negatively correlated. First, we used to go with the Pearson correlation method. So you see over here, we have got two series, X series, and we have got Y series. This is Y series. In the sum of the pieces side, we have seen. So they have given the ages of husband in X series and the ages of wife in Y series. Means when the boy get married, the ages of the boys when they became husband is this, and the girls when they became wife, the age is this one. Now the first thing to calculate the Carl Friedrich coefficient method is to take out the value, mean value of X series and the mean value of Y series. So for calculating the mean value, the simple formula is this, that you sum up of the value, add all these things, add all the values over here and write over here. So the total of this value is 300. Okay, so put the value of X series over here and add it, you have got 300. Means summation, addition of this. Now take the ages of wife, all the values, and add over here, put it over here, summation sign. So 204 is the total of age of wife. Now for calculating the mean value of husband, mean value, we have got formula summation M upon N, means summation M, this is M, upon N. N is the number of terms, how many terms? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So 12 are the terms, so we write 12 over here and we have got 25 as the mean value of husband. Now for same way, the mean value of Y, total is 204, we write 204, same way 12 numbers are here, 12, we get the value 17 over here, right? So this is the way we calculate the mean. Now after mean, we have to calculate the standard deviation, because in the formula I have told you that you have to divide the value of summation xy from n summation 1 into summation 2. So for the standard deviation of X series, we have got the formula summation d square upon n. So there will be another row which we form from taking the value of the mean value. So here the mean value is 25. 25 minus 25 is equal to 0. 22 minus 25 is equal to minus 3. 28 minus 25 is plus 3. 26 minus 25 is plus 1. 35 minus 25 plus 10 minus 25 minus 25. So everywhere you have to do minus 25 minus 25, because 25 is the mean value. So you have to subtract every value of this side from 25, because the mean value is 25. Same way, in this series, you have got the mean deviation 17. 17 is the mean value. So from this series, from Y series, you have to subtract 17. Like this. 18 minus 17 is equal to 1. 15 minus 17 is equal to minus 2. Like this, you have to subtract each and every value like this. You see, you have to subtract each and every value of Y series from 17, as the 17 is the mean value and you get the deviation, that is whether it is positively deviated or the negatively deviated. Now we have to take that deviation square, means the value of this, as you see that some of the values are in the negative terms, to make it in a positive term, we have to square up the values. So here 0 into 0, 3 into 3, into 3, into 1, into 10, into 5, into 3, into 15, into 5, into 7, into 6, into 0, means the value which is being given here is, we are going to multiply the same value from is 0 into 0, 0, 3 into minus 3 is equal to 9, 3 into 3, 9, 1, 1, 1, 10 into 10 is 100, 5 into 5 is 25. Means the same value which is being here, we are going to multiply the same value on this side. Same we are going to here, to here, that derivation is here. We have to multiply the value from the given value. Into 3, into 1, into 4, into 2, into 3, into 2, into 0. Right? So, you have got the y series, you have taken the mean value, you subtracted the value, you have got the deviation. Now, the value which you have got in the deviation, you are going to multiply the deviation from the same value and you have got the deviation square. Now, when you have got the deviation square, you are going to get the product of the deviation. That is, you have to multiply this value from that value. This will, you will get the plus 186. Now, if you remember, I have told you the formula for calculating the Karl-Pearson correlation. That is, summation xy, standard deviation of 1, standard deviation of 2. Here, the value is given over here. Standard deviation, the value of standard deviation is given over here. You have got the deviation square, d square. The value is given over here, 488, right over here. N, number of terms, 12 terms are here, right over here. 488 divided by 12, you take under root of it. You will get a value 6.38 for X series, that is husband, and for Y series, for wife, you have got 204 total over here. So 82 is the deviation square, deviation square, this you have to write over here, 82 deviation square. Number of terms, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. That is 12 value. Under root it and you will get a value over 2.61. Right? So, you have got all the three values. Putting up in the values, you have got 186, 12, standard deviation of x is 6.38 and standard deviation of y is 2.61, which is, when you solve this, you will get the value which is over here. You can see that the coefficient of, how you are going to calculate the coefficient of correlation, this is the formula. I have put the value over here. In the last slide you have seen that I have put the value over here, 186 is the deviation of x and y series, 12 is the number of terms which we have taken, 6.38 is the standard deviation of x series, and 2.61 is the standard deviation of y series. This is n and this is summation xy. When we calculate this, this we get plus 9307, means the age of husband and the age of wife are highly positive correlated. Okay, now we take another example of rank correlation. This is the example which we have taken for all those who are dealing with the quantified data. Quantified data means the exact number. For example, age. Age is the exact number. But what happened if we have got a data in rank? So when the data is in rank, we used to apply a method which is applicable for the quantified data. So for the quantified data, we have to take another example, another method that is known as the Spearman rank correlation. So here you can see the question says that the rank of 10 students in two subjects, A and B, are as under. Means there are two subjects and the rank of 10 students are this. Is that the rank? Means the number which they have got in the examination. For example, take A as maths and B as commerce. So this is the rank of students in maths and this is the rank of students in commerce. Means the first student has got the third rank in maths, the paper of maths, and he has got the sixth rank in paper of commerce. So student one, and we have taken the rank, and student rank B here over here. So for putting the rank, we have to take the ascending order or the descending order. And when we put the rank in a series like this, we take out the difference of the rank. For example, 3 minus 6 is equal to minus 3, 5 minus 4 is equal to plus 1, 8 minus 9 is equal to minus 1, 4 minus 8 is equal to minus 4, 7 minus 1 is equal to plus 6, 10 minus 2 is equal to plus 8, 2 minus 3 is equal to minus 1, 1 minus 10 is equal to minus 9, 6 minus 5 is equal to plus 1, 9 minus 7 is equal to plus 2. So what over here is this? We have got the rank difference, D. So you remember the first slide where I have told you the formula for calculating the Spearman rank correlation, that is minus 6 summation d square upon n square minus 1. Right? So we have taken the rank of A series, rank of B series, take out the difference, we have taken the difference over here, and we have squared up the value. The square of the value means multiplying by the same value. So this is the value which you will get by multiplying the terms. This is a 9, 1, 1, 1, 6, 6, 36, 8, 8, 64, 1, 9, 9, 81. Means, and you sum up of the value, add all the value, you will get up the summation. And this summation is summation d square is equal to 214, as you have got d square, d over here. So x and y series, and 214 is the summation d square. Now putting the value on the formula, this is the formula and we have to put the value. One is a constant as we have taken from the formula, no problem. 6 is also a constant value into 214 d square, the value of d square is 214. 10, number of terms, 10 over here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 10. Put the 10 over here, 10 square minus 1, as n square minus 1 over here. Solve it, you will get a value minus 0.296. Means the two ranks are negatively correlated. Means the student which has got a good rank in maths is not a good rank in commerce. Means he hasn't have performed in a same manner in both the paper, because the two ranks are negatively correlated. So these are the two most important methods which is being highly used in business, commerce, economics for calculation of the correlation. Today we have seen that how we have to calculate the correlation by the Karl Pearson method and Spearman method. In the next lecture, we will take the concurrent deviation method. There are two references book which you can use for the future reading. I hope you have understand how to calculate the correlation by the help of that data in qualitative method and the quantitative method. Thank you.